Hello, welcome to Coffee and Hair Talk. So, I sip a coffee and now we're talking. By demand from a few stylists, numerous stylists, I want to talk today about a lumen removal. How do you remove a lumen? We all know what a lumen is by now. We know that is the most permanent or durable hair color. And we also know that it just functions differently than your oxidative hair color. When it comes to a lumen, obviously all rules fall apart. Everything that you know about hair color is totally different. So a lumen lives in its own bubble, and so it has its own rules. In order to be successful with a lumen, you have to apply and respect those rules. And we talked about that when we actually talked about what a lumen is and how it works. Because lumen works on a physical process rather than a chemical process, we know that in order for us to remove a lumen, we need to reverse that physical process. So if a lumen deposits in the hair with or through a magnetic attraction, now we have to depolarize that attraction in order to take a lumen out. A lumen will be expelled, or you can return or minimize the amount of a lumen in the hair. So all being said, I know all of you, when you use a lumen, you're always going for pinks and reds and fluorescent colors, and that's perfectly fine. But my question is, if you would have used any other color, oxidative hair color, if it would have been bright orange or bright red, what were the chances of you to remove that permanently and very easy and very fast and get a clean blonde? Because this is what people are requesting. How do I get a clean blonde after I just had hair colored with a lumen RR at all or PK at all? Now, you'll be surprised that aluminum removal is not so complicated. You just have to have a little more patience, because you can't just use, you know, a high developer, I use 40 volume and pre-lightener, and you think that's gonna come out. That just doesn't work. So pre-lightener doesn't really work on aluminum as well as it works on Top Chic or any other hair color, oxidative hair color. So we do have a product that's called Return. So what Return does, depolarizes the charges in the hair. And talking about charges, you remember lumen is negatively charged and attaches itself inside the hair on a positive charge. So that's magnetic attraction, that's how it works. So definitely what you need to do, you just need to decouple that lumen, just pull it apart from the positive charge. So reverse magnetism, and Return does that, just depolarizes, so it just kind of changes the charges. Lumen is negative, so the positive charge that lumen is attached to, it just becomes negative. So now negative and negative, they do not attract each other. The magnets don't work like that. So now your lumen is free. It is not in a leash anymore. It's not attached to anything. Now it's free in the hair. You will have to help it come out of the hair and squeeze it through the cuticle. So every time you apply Return, it has to be done on dry hair. You have to saturate the hair. And what works for me the best, and it might not be 100% by manufacturing instruction, but you're not breaking any rules, I would apply, saturate the hair with Return, just cover the hair with a plastic bag, add a heat source. A Hair Master is an amazing heat source, and then it's not gonna create any damage. You need to help that hair to expel the lumen out of the hair. So, and every 15 minutes, you'll see, right away, you'll see the result. When you put the Return, it's just, you're gonna see it color comes out. So leave it on for 15 minutes. Make sure you protect the hairline with the cotton so you don't have any drippings. 15 minutes under the source, the heat source, and then you take that plastic bag and you really squeegee, you squeeze out all that Return. Make sure you get as much as possible and then reapply. Now, by manufacturer instructions, we are supposed to shampoo the hair, dry it, and then reapply. That's how manufacturer's rules are. Now, I feel that is a little bit time consuming, and I feel that numerous shampoos, as they can't, you know, the scalp gets too tight and too dry at one point. So I'm just piggybacking this Return application every 15 minutes and squeezing and squeezing it out until it comes out as clean as possible. Now, you might not get the lumen out of the hair 100%, but you can have an amazing result. After all, lumen is the most durable hair color. It is the most permanent hair color. The last thing it wants to do is come out of the hair easy. So please be reasonable when you're trying to take lumen out in 15 minutes, because that's not going to happen. Especially after 10, 15, 20 layers of lumen, RR or whatever intensive pigment you chose for that particular hair. So please be reasonable and understand Illumen doesn't stand for fading fast, it stands for durability. So Illumen does and follows the promise. It is us that we want to change. We want Illumen in the hair, we want it to be durable, but we also want it to come out really, really fast. Now, you can be very successful with return, but the longer the Illumen is in the hair, let's say if you've done Illumen applications for like 2 years, you can't really get it all out in one application. So you might need to repeat those applications a few times. It's not going to change the integrity of the hair, so it's not going to affect the hair structure at all. But obviously, the source, the fact the return is alkaline, but it's not oxidative, so it has nothing to do with structural damage, that's going to keep the hair in a very healthy state. But also, if it feels a little bit dry, it's because also the shampoos and the heat and so on and so forth. So, you know, moisturizing treatment or another Illumen application could literally make the hair feel very good right after. Now, if you're not very successful with return, a lot of times actually, and we used to teach this, but we're not anymore for whatever reason, I still do it. So I'm talking to you from my colorist perspective, not the educator. A lot of times I will mix Silk Lift with return to see if I can get both things, the best of both worlds at the same time. However, it will be slower. If you don't want to use them both at the same time, you can use the Silk Lift first and then see if you need to do any more removal of Illumen. Maybe you can use a return after. So it is up to you. I'm mixing to a formula, a regular formula of a Silk Lift, and 6% or 3%, and I'll get back to you on that in a second. I will put about 30 mils of return. So it will be a little bit watery, but not a problem because now we have the thickener, so you can actually add the thickener and thicken it, or it's just apply it carefully and just saturate the hair and just wait and be patient. Do not apply any heat. We do not recommend, and I don't use any heat with any pre-lightening services. I just don't believe in it. I don't think it's necessary to rush anything when you compare what you can lose. The integrity of the hair, for me, it's really way more important than finishing a color process or color remover or pre-lightening service 15 minutes earlier. So I'm not compromising on hair quality whatsoever. I was talking to you about the Silk Lift and formulation on that. Every time I used a high developer, and I tried everything because I wanted to see what results I can get, every time I used the Silk Lift on illuminized hair, the lower the developer, the better the results. Don't ask me why, I just tell you the results are much better. The hair feels much better when I'm using 10 or 20 volume maximum, because you do not have a problem lifting the hair. You're gonna have a problem lifting the Illumen out of the hair. So you don't even know exactly what level the hair is unless all the Illumen is out. So I'm trying to combine a lot of times return with Silk Lift, and I will get the best of both worlds. Now it is up to you which way you want to try that. For me it works, but also you will need to know where you're going every time when you decide on a formulation of Illumen. So if the client is very unstable and what she wants and the results that she would like and what hair color she would like, if she doesn't know for sure what she wants, don't just go big and bright in one set, because what if she wants blonde again? So take it easy, make sure that she wants that hair, and then use it. Because once you go to a PK at all, a pink, fluorescent pink, or R at all, or KK, you can't really just take it all out unless you do it right after the Illumen application. So let's say you color the hair, she goes home, she hates it. Your chances to remove Illumen are better to do it right away, next day, that week. The longer Illumen is in the hair, the better and more comfortable it becomes, which that actually makes it much harder for you to remove. Again, if I would have to put, I'll make a list of my favorite things, how do I remove Illumen or minimize the Illumen deposit in the hair, I will say return, Silk Lift, and also 12 series. I really like using 12BS or 12BN we have two. We have only two left with 30 volume or even 40 volume. And now depending on the quality of the hair, but I really love the results that I get because it will give me a less vibrancy after the removal of Illumen than Silk Lift or Oxycure Platine. You need to try and see and you decide which way it's best for you. I really love the 12 series though because it's almost like not removing Illumen, obviously alkalinity will depolarize the hair, will depolarize it because the alkalinity and ammonia. And so the Illumen will be detached from the positive charge, which already became negative. And therefore it's loose, but it's not a fast aggressive lift. It is almost like a scrub. It's almost like just taking it layer and layer of color, just slowly, slowly. And I really, really love the results. So you pick your favorite way. And obviously if the results are not perfectly clean, because you're not gonna get a perfect clean result, don't forget that you need to even out the hair color after. So then to fix that, we'll talk about it in a different chapter. And don't forget, every time you do a color correction, there's no such a thing in advanced color. It's all basic, it's just like a puzzle. You just put all your basic knowledge together to create a beautiful picture. And so there's no magic formula, it's just hard work and just put your mind to it, you can do it. As long as you do not sacrifice the hair quality. I hope this was helpful for those of you who are trying to take Illumen out of the hair, remove Illumen or minimize it. If you need if you have any questions, if you need any help with anything else, I'm here for you. Subscribe or message me on Instagram, Rodica68. I'm willing and very, very happy to answer your questions. So have a great day and good luck with Illumen. See you soon.